first heard Queen's Right was about 2 years ago. I was very impressed. It was so different. Just putting the album on right from the beginning, it was a different sound. And I was really thrilled by that. So when I'd heard that the Queen's Right album, you know, they were actually looking for a producer for the new one, I was very interested, and I thought, well, I'm going to go and run after this one to see if they'd be interested in me.
Working with our producer, Neil Kernan, on this project has been a real pleasure, because Neil is a perfectionist, which means he fits in with us real well. And he's also a slave driver, which means we're getting a lot done in a very short amount of time. And he's done a lot of different acts, ranging from rock to pop, which is one reason why we got involved with him.
I felt that what we should really do is go all the way, get a mobile unit, mobile recording unit, go out to some really, really bashy live room, just not restrict, again, you know, by the same token, not restrict the way the album could turn out.
The way that we got the drum sound on this record was we were looking for an extremely live and aggressive sound. So we spent about 2 weeks in the Seattle area looking for the right room, which we finally found in terms of a huge stone warehouse that we, it was a business park and everything, so we got that. And we brought up Lay Mobile, which is a mobile recording studio. And we spent about 5 days getting the right sounds and doing all the tracks within those 5 days. Accomplished that and moved on to the bass tracks.
We expect to be touring sometime in July, early summer. We expect to hopefully tour Japan and Canada. We will be touring the States. We would definitely love to go to Australia.
As far as guitars and things like that, obviously with Michael and Chris, both have a very distinctive sound. We've been trying to maximize that. We haven't been straying too far with processing and stuff like that. I think when we get down to the mix, which we haven't done yet, we will be experimenting with several different sounds then.
It took about 3 or 4 days to get the guitar sound that we were happy with. Mm-hmm. We must have tried at least 15 different speaker and amplifier combinations. We finally ended up using these two old Marshall amplifiers that were on the verge of exploding, which gave us the right sound we needed, this edge and tension for the album.
One of the most exciting parts of the project has been actually working with Jeff, because Jeff's voice is incredibly versatile. There really aren't that many singers who can do what he can do as well as he can do it. I think the overall thing is going to be fairly hard-hitting. I think we have maintained the Queensryche identity. There's a couple of major tracks which are just very, very heavy.
That's about it, folks, right, commuters?